Now I'm going to introduce you to a lazy version of the RC memory model, and it's called LRC, stands for Lazy RC. Now this is the structure of your parallel program. So a thread acquires a lock, does the data accesses, releases the lock, another thread may acquire the same lock, and if the critical section for P1 precedes the critical section for P2, then the RC memory model requires that at the point of release, you ensure that all the modifications that have been made on processor P1, that is, the coherence actions that are commensurate with those data accesses, are all communicated to all the peer processors, including P2, then you release the lock. That's the semantic. And this is what is called eager release consistency, meaning that at the point of release, you're ensuring that the whole system is cache coherent. The whole system is cache coherent at the point of release, then you're releasing the lock. And the cache coherence is with respect to the set of data accesses that have gone on this processor up to this point. That's what we are ensuring has been communicated and made consistent on all the processors. Now let's say that the timeline looks like this, and P1's release happened at this point, and P2's acquire of the same lock happened at a much later point in time. That's the luck of the draw in terms of how the computation went. And so there is this time window between P1's release of the lock and P2's acquisition of the same lock. Now, if you think about it, there's an opportunity for procrastination. Now, we saw that procrastination often helps in system design. We've seen this in mutual exclusion locks. If you insert delay between successive trials of trying to get the lock, that actually results in better performance. We saw that in processor scheduling too. Instead of eagerly scheduling the next available task, maybe you want to wait for a task that has more affinity to your processor. That results in performance advantage. So procrastination often is a good friend of system design. So here again, there is an opportunity for procrastination. So lazy RC is another instance where procrastination may actually help in optimizing the system performance. The idea is that rather than performing all the coherence actions at the point of release, don't do it. Procrastinate. Wait till the acquire actually happens. At the point of acquire, take all the coherence actions before allowing this acquire to succeed. So the key point is that you're deferring the point at which you ensure that all the coherence actions are complete to the point of acquisition as opposed to the point of release. Even if all the coherence actions commensurate with the data accesses that have gone on up until this release point are not yet complete when we hit the release, go ahead, release the lock. But if the next lock acquisition happens, at that point, make sure that all the coherence actions are complete. So in other words, you get an opportunity to overlap computation with communication once again in this window of time between the release of a lock and the acquisition of the same lock.